Students, my name is Pranati. I am a new English teacher for your academic year. So, how are you, students? I see you all are good. Please, students, stay home and stay safe. Don't go out, don't play out. Please, live in the home, live quietly, do your works, and enjoy and play in your house itself. Don't go out, okay? Okay, students, today I am going to start your lesson in your academic year, that is peace and harmony. So, dear children, what is peace? What is peace? You know it. Okay, I'll tell you one example, students. You are having exam tomorrow. You are having an exam tomorrow. You are preparing for it. Suddenly, your relatives came into your house. And all small children were creating a hell of noise, okay? So then how will you study? What will you, what you want? What do you want? What kind of environment do you want? You want peace. You want silence, right? That is called as peace. That silence is called as peace. Yes. Next, harmony. So what is harmony? By living together peacefully, that means you study with your friend for tomorrow's exam. You study with your friend for tomorrow's exam. How will you study? Both will study, no? So you'll study in a very peaceful environment. So you both will don't make a noise, right? That is called as harmony. Okay. Now I think now you understand what is peace and what is harmony. So let us enter into our chapter, our lesson. Okay, students. So, before beginning the lesson, I'll show one picture for you. So, this is a picture. This is a picture, students. What kind of a picture is it? What can you observe in this picture? So, students, there are some animals, right? There are some animals you can observe. So, where they are? They are in a forest. How they are? They are sitting together. They are chatting with one another. Like your, what you do? Like your... friends and you, what you do in a free time, you chit chat, right? Like that, only these animals are doing. So these are chit chatting with one another in a very happy way. So you can see tiger, you can see deer, and you can see this giraffe, you can see elephant. Actually, tiger and deer, they are enemies, no? Tiger and deer, these two are enemies, right? Then why they are sitting together? Tiger will hunt deer, no? Then why they are sitting together? So, after listening this lesson, you will come to know what is the meaning in this picture and why they are sitting like this, what is the happiness in the picture, you will come to know. Okay, students, now let's go with reading. Read the following story and answer the questions that follow. Okay. So, once upon a time, in a very thick forest, there lived many animals, birds, snakes and insects. They all lived together happily. They roamed about the jungle and played together in the open fields without any fear. The peacocks were very proud of their dances but admired the melodious songs of the cuckoos. So once upon a time there was a forest. How was it? It was very thick, okay? It was very thick forest. Thick means the forest was having so many trees surrounded with it, okay? That's why it's called as thick forest. So there lived many animals like birds, snakes and insects. They all lived together happily. Those all animals lived together happily. So students, thick I said, right? T-H-I-C-K, thick. It means it's very, it's surrounded with so many trees and so many plants. The forest is very messy. Okay, students. So, in the thick forest, the light cannot enter. Okay. So, they roamed about the jungle and played together in open fields without any fear. So, these animals were very happy. They don't have any kind of fear. Why? Because they were like a friends. I sent you in the picture. There is a forest and the deer. And they're chit-chatting. There is a forest and there is a tiger and a deer. and they're chit-chatting. Actually, these are animals, these are enemies now. So the why they will chit-chat? So that's why I'm saying this. Why they are chit-chatting means they are, they, these all animals live like a friends. Okay? They don't have any polluted minds. They live like a friends. So they don't have any fear that someone will, that some animal will come and attack us like that. They don't have any kind of fear. The peacocks were very proud of the dances but admired the melodious songs of cuckoos. So you know peacocks, in a rain the peacock, what will it do? It will dance, no? It will do very, very beautiful dance. Very beautiful dance it does, you know. So the elephants enjoyed watching the fish swimming in the pool. The elephants enjoyed watching the fish swimming in the pool. So fish, you can see the fish swimming in the pool, no? Very beautifully they roam here and there in a swimming pool, no? So likewise, how we enjoy, like seeing in aquarium, how fishes will go. Okay? Like that only, these elephants were seeing in a pool how the fishes swim, and this was enjoying that. This elephant was enjoying that. The tiny ants, which were always busy, tickled, and the dark buffaloes. Here, you underline the word tickled. Okay, students, tickled. Tickled means what ant will do? Some poking, no? It will always poke us, no? Some kind of touch. Some little touch. So some little touch is called as tickled. So the insect, the tiny ants which were always busy tickled, and dark buffaloes, they often held musical evenings in a large open field. So in the ants, you know, ants always, it will be busy in actually on the buffalo, the ants will be present. What it will do, it will be going on tickling the buffalo. It will going on disturbing us. The humans and the buffaloes and in anything, okay? So the ant will be very, the ant is very busy thing, very busy one ant. So that ant also was enjoying with them. So you can see, children, how happy they are, how happy these animals are. The elephant and the deer danced, the rhinos and the parrot sang, the tiger and the bear exhibited gymnastics. So children, these animals were very enjoying with their own soundings, own dancings. They are creating their own musical world around them, you know. See, the parrots were singing, the parrots and rhinos were singing. And elephants and deer are dancing with them. The tiger and bear exhibited gymnastics. You know what is gymnastics? This is hard to spell, but you have to learn it. Gym, see children, gymnastics. Okay? So what is gymnastics? Gymnastics is a physical exercises. It's a physical exercise. You know what is physical exercise? In a circus, you'll see some circus feats, no? In a circus, you might have seen the circus. So those feats are called as physical exercises. So that is called as gymnastics. Okay then. They call the moon and its friends stars to be guests of the honor at the musical evenings. So they were enjoying a lot. They were enjoying a lot by using their own characters, by singing, by dancing. So they invited the guest. Who was the guest? Moon and stars are the guest. Okay. One day a jackal entered the forest. So one day what happened? Jackal entered the forest. Who is the jackal? Jackal is an animal. So that jackal entered the forest. So what he is doing, we'll see. He was dirty, dangerous, and very cunning. He was very dangerous fellow. See, he was dirty, dangerous, and very cunning on that trips. He told the elephants. So cunning. Please underline the word children. Cunning. You have to find out the meaning of a cunning. Okay, this is your homework. You have to find out the meaning. He told the elephants, "You are the biggest animals in the forest. Why do you want to play with the squirrels and the rabbits?" See how he started his work. He started polluting other animals also. He started disturbing the animals. You know, they was very friendly. He want to disturb them. He want to create a boundary among them. See how he's doing. So he went to the elephant and he was saying, "You were the elephant. You were very biggest animal in the forest. Then why you're playing with the squirrels and rabbits? Those are small animals. Why you're playing with them?" Likewise, it started asking them. So he poisoned the mind of the peacocks, saying, "You are the loveliest birds in the forest. Why do you want to play the minas?" Yeah, see how he's doing. He went to the peacock and he is saying that, "You are very good one, you are very loveliest one. Then why you are starting praising the minas? Why you are praising the minas?" Praising. So mandala the word praise. Praise means a kind of appreciation. You know pogadatam. It's a kind of appreciation. So you think what it was saying is, what it wanted to say is, what the jackal wanted to say is, peacock, you are very loveliest one. You think yourself proud. Why you are praising other one? Why you are appreciating the other one? It's not good, right? So this jackal, what he is doing, you see, he is polluting the minds of other animals. He is creating the disturbance among themselves. Gradually all the animals began suspecting one another. Earlier they have lived together, slept together, and roamed around the forest together. So you underline the other word, suspecting. So this is also your homework. You have to find out the meaning for it. So all the animals began suspecting one another. Earlier they have lived together, slept together, and roamed around the forest together. Now they started to put the boundaries. See, the animals also like that only. See, if anyone will come and say about your friend, you will believe. No, but sometimes you will believe. Like that they will say, your friend is bad, he will not give you his lunch. Like that they will say something bad about your friends, and you will also start believing. Like that some people will be like a jackal. So here what he did, he created a distance among themselves, among those animals. They was very friendly in the starting. So now they are creating some disturbances among themselves only. They are creating themselves jealous, you know, jealous feelings. Earlier they had lived together, slept together, and roamed around the forest. Now they started put up boundaries. See, they started putting a boundaries among themselves. So what are boundaries? A borderline among themselves. They will not cross the borderlines like that. Okay? Themselves they are creating a boundaries that no such animal should enter into the boundaries. Now it was easy to the jackal to hunt the smaller animals and the birds. See what the jackal is thinking. Actually, it wanted to hurt the smaller animals. So actually they were these all animals are unity. They all are unite. So if they all are unite, it is not possible to hunt the smaller animals. No, it is not possible to hunt them. So that's why the jackal is creating the distance among them. That one is dividing them. Okay. So now they all are, they created boundaries among themselves. And when the smaller ones cried out for a help, no one came to help them. So now they are understanding what the jackal has done to them. So they are asking for a help. They are asking for a help, but no one is there for helping them, because they among themselves only created them the boundaries. So after getting this one by one, one small animal, they started crying. But no one is there for help. Dear children, you have to understand that. See, unity is very important. Okay, students. So we have again continuation. Tomorrow I'll continue in the tomorrow classes. Okay, students, now you have to, what you have to do is you have to find out the meanings for these two words, okay? And you have to create your own sentences for these two words. Okay, students. So thank you, students. We'll end up this session.